Right.
So soon after the shooting and the event, we began working with our architects to sort of develop plans to present to our school board for accommodations for the building to make it safe if needed, and add additional space for entries as well as areas within the school outside of the art room area. So since then, we've had our vestibules. This is an additional entry area that's been reconfigured to allow for metal detectors. Our metal detectors were approved recently.
Right.
And so there'll be four metal detectors that the public will come through, and students that come in this way in the mornings. Some are dropped off in the front area,
right,
and the majority of students come in the side entrance by the auditorium, and there'll be three metal detectors there, and then a few from the bus area, there'll be two metal detectors in the back there. So this particular section of the school was redesigned to allow for a larger secure entry area, so the metal detectors will fit and it'll be easy to process. The remaining pieces down the elective hall area, which is the area that you toured, there were some adjustments made from the dance room area, which was close to the area of the shooting, and relocated to another area that allowed for a bit of an expansion, which will be nice for those girls on that team. And then also an additional corridor to access the back hallway, which will serve our ag departments and ag rooms, and allow for another exit area into the back of the school.
I think this high school is going to be sending out some tips and instructions and procedures this week, and they'll put that in there, is that this would be the quickest
art rooms, at least at this point in time, will not be accessible. So that area will strictly be closed off and not open for traffic. So the reconfiguration of the hallways allows for traffic to flow around it.
Has there been any decision on what future use of that area may be?
Discussion, but not decision. So at this point, our focus has been on preparing what needed to happen to get school started on the 20th, and to make sure that it's ready, and it will be. So we will have all of these pieces completed and in good order for kids to come. So we have initially approved additional police officers. So we had 8 full-time, and Chief can speak more to this, but we had 8 full-time. We've added 5. And we've also added 10 security assistants, and those individuals will be, and this would be district-wide, and those individuals will be available during the day to monitor the exterior, to monitor doors on the interior, to monitor the hallways for badges, dress code as well, and to just generally ensure security within the building. So in addition to that, we added 4 counselors, trauma-specific trained counselors, so that when our students and staff return, they will have support in that area specifically. And so our teachers have been training, and those counselors have had specific training on what we might want to do and implement for those kids and teachers when they come back to school. The 4 counselors and those areas that you saw back there will accommodate offices for that group. They have been hired and will be ready to start at the beginning of school. So they're on board.
I was about to ask, are you at full staff on extra positions and general?
With the exception of police officers. I think he's working on that, but I think otherwise we have a couple of those, and you can ask Chief a little bit more about that. I think there were many things happening concurrently. So after the event, our first task was to ensure that we take care of our people. So our community, our kids, our families, to get them back to school, finish out school, have a successful graduation. And then we were gonna start looking towards what we needed to put in place so that we could ensure and secure the buildings and make sure people felt safe. Students, parents, staff coming back to school on August 20th. So we initially began the process of planning through that. At the same time, putting in place a safety and security committee that could long-term look at many different options that we would consider as we go forward. Our first task was, what can we get accomplished before school starts? And that was really what our focus was. And so that was the first piece. Initially, and we didn't talk about this, but in addition to the changes in the building, we also will be increasing and adding secure alarms in the doors, additional locks for the classroom doors, as well as fire alarm panic button in classrooms. So those are some of the things that were in the works, as well as working with architects to redesign in the first couple of weeks, in addition to us helping establish the National Compassion Fund and some of those pieces too. So while I understand concerns that it didn't appear that things were happening, lots of things were happening, and then trying to work and build in some of our stakeholders, our community, to start looking in those decisions. Metal detectors is a great example. So we knew some of the things that needed to happen immediately in terms of building, but the metal detectors was one that we wanted weigh in on. So the Safety and Security Committee began discussing it. We sent out many, many surveys, and both responses were overwhelmingly, yes, we feel like we would feel safer with metal detectors in our schools. So there's where we are now. So that process, while it doesn't seem immediate, was certainly taken seriously and continued from day one, really. So, and so now we're looking at, this is what we have in place, we're ready to start school, but we'll continue to assess and review and listen to the safety committee. They're now working in subcommittees that will bring recommendations ongoing throughout the year, and then assess the end of the year, and then look forward for the future as well. So we'll continue to evaluate and see what's working and what's not working, and we'll look forward to feedback from our community on that as well. And we appreciate that. We do like to hear what are you thinking. So that's always good information for us, and that's what helped make the decision for the metal detectors. Is this overwhelmingly people felt like this would be something that would be important for our students and staff and parents to feel safe coming back to school. So we have worked around Meet the Teacher Nights and some of the back to school events and ball games and those things, and settled on next Thursday evening at 7 p.m. It will be following Junior High Meet the Teacher Night, so we can make sure that there's no conflicts there. But the purpose would be to share as much information as we possibly can, factual information, twofold. One is things that we had in place prior to this event, and then things that we have put in place, and then things that we'll still consider in the future to put in place. And our intent, of course, to share the information, as much information as we can. We have invited questions into the portal so that we could address them there. We'll also have the representative from the metal detector company to kind of speak to that a little bit. So our hope is that we can provide information, give people the opportunity to hear from us and ask any questions through that meeting, and then possibly after, if we don't answer questions, we'll follow up at a later time with those as well.
For a parent that has doubts right now about their student returning, what could you say to him or her as best you could to assure them that come August 20th, it's going to be safe to return to any campus in Santa Fe ISD?
So I think that it's going to be difficult in many ways for many people to return, but I also think it's going to be a great opportunity for us to come together and to pull together as a community from parents and students and really work to make our schools the safest, best, better than before even, and that parents feel confident, are trusting that we are doing everything we can, and I can assure you we have considered, we'll continue to consider everything that we possibly can so that everyone that comes through these schools, parents, teachers, staff, community, friends, will feel confident and safe, and I would like to say safest school in the nation. So I would say that I would hope that that they trust, and that we start building back that trust that we're going to have safe schools, and we're doing everything we can to make that happen, because our kids deserve it and their future deserves it, and the future of education, really, because we're building something that needs to continue in the future, so that everybody is attuned to the reality that can happen. If it can happen here, it can happen anywhere. So everyone needs to be aware of that fact and increase that awareness overall. We certainly have.